Hello everyone, this is time of year again where we got a new tutorial. With Vanguard coming out in a couple of days, I figured it'd be the right time to make a new tutorial on how to sync. Since my last tutorial, I've definitely changed my syncing style completely, so let's get right into it. So I have my song here, Innerwave by Rose. If you want to just look here, I have my audio waves here. You just drag it to your timeline, pretty easy. If you want to preview audio, you press the period on your number pad on your keyboard. And if you want to make markers, you press the star, or yeah, the star on your number pad also, just so we have everything set out, like this. In this video, I'm not going to be doing that though, just for time sake purposes, which I don't do very much anymore, but if you like to do that, that's how you do it. And if you want to set it on certain layers, select a layer and then press the key. So everything we're going by here is going to be on Twixtor. It's a plugin that you download. You can find it somewhere on the internet. So first, what we're going to be doing is I'm going to be starting out showing how I set up the beginning of my clips. We're going to be looking at the beginning audio right here. We're going to preview it. So we're going to drag our clip in here. So what you're going to do is you want to find the point of where you want your first shot to be at by previewing your audio. I want to be right there at that drop. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to drag this timeline over until I see the first shot. And what we're going to do is we're going to go to the frame where we see the bullet flare, which is going to be right there. And you're going to press Control Shift D to cut the layer in half like that. And then you're going to go back to beginning where you want the first clip to show up, which is going to be right here. So you want to click Control Shift D. Okay, cool, another split right there. I'm gonna click on this, delete it, so it's not there anymore. We have right here to build to the first shot. Next, you're gonna do is you're gonna go through the whole second layer right here, and you're gonna go through and find each shot for each bullet flare like that. And we have all of our clips cut right here, so each shot is divided by a different layer. So now what you wanna do is you wanna go through every piece of audio, and you're gonna figure out where you want your clips, your shots to be at in the audio. So I want mine to be right here. Right here. It's usually good to have one or two beats between each shot so you have time to sync the clip on a beat. If you want to drag over a clip by clicking one button, you just select a layer, bring your marker right here on your timeline to a certain point so you can see the audio layer right here, you can see the beat right here. You just click the left or right bracket to bring the beginning or end clip to your point. Alright, perfect. So now I have all my clips on the set beats that I want. And then after the last shot, you're going to figure out where you went to the last beat to end to the next or next cinematic. So I'll be right here on the second beat for just this song specifically. Sometimes I do one beat, sometimes I do two, sometimes I do three, depends on what the song is. Alright, so first you're going to go onto your layer right here, and you're going to go to your effects tab, which yours would probably be in the top left up here somewhere, but I have mine down here just for easier purposes. So you want to look up Twixtor once you have it installed. I personally do Twixtor Pro just because there's more options and it's also easier just to use in my opinion. This clip right here I have specifically set is recorded 120 FPS, but yours is more than likely recorded in 60 FPS. And the different values you're going to do is up here, so the frame rate you want to change it to 30 if you have 30 FPS clips, 60 if 60 FPS clips, and then 120 if 120 FPS clips. I have 120 right here, so I'm going to stick to that. Once you have your Twixtor set on here, and you have your frame rate correct like this, you want to click on the speed time watch right here on the first frame. So you can see you have 100 speed right here, which is going to be the beginning first frame of our clip. You don't want to change that one. You want to go one frame forward to the beat, and you want to go and set this to a certain speed. So for example, like a song like this with this melody and this speed. So I don't want to do anything super crazy. So the way the speed works is how fast the clip is going to be going. So if I do 300, as you can see, the clip's going to be going super fast. As you can see right there. So now what you're going to do is you want to set the first keyframe to what you want. So I'm personally going to do, we'll say 175 on this song. And then once you set the keyframe, you're going to want to go to the next spot for the beginning clip. And you can do this way either. I'll show you both ways. So you can either do a point like this where you go to 50 like this. And then at the end, you can go do to like a 175 also. So it's an even amount. So it's a 175, 50, 175. Or you can do something like this, where you can drag this over and have it be 50 from the beginning, gradually get to 175. For this purpose, majority of the time people are going to do this, which is called a U strategy. So once you have your 3 points like this, and you have the one keyframe before the next shot like this, you're going to want to drag your box over these 3 points and click F9 and easy ease them. Or click on them and click on a keyframe assistant and then ease. And then you can see that they're now time glasses. You want to highlight one of these points or click on the speed right here. I'm going to click on the graph editor right here in this corner. And as you can see, we have a U shape right here with our 3 points. This is where most of the speed comes in and a lot of the foundation of the syncing comes in for later on the whole montage. So what we're going to do is we're going to drag This point right here on the left side top U and drag it down, maybe like right here, like down like 75%, and then the same thing on this side. And then on the bottom point right here, you want to drag these out just a little bit so it creates a nice smooth U like this. So it's a nice smooth pattern. And then if you want your shots or your points to be more harsh, which they're sinking, like they're faster near the end or slower near the end, you can drag this up or down. So this one, make it so it picks up speed more gradually, or it'll bring it down more and it'll get, pick up speed the last second like this. I like to have it like at 75% just to keep a nice smooth pace. And once you have that set, you can go and you can see that we have a U speed. So as you can see, it's fast, slow, and then fast again. And you can see this isn't synced correctly. So what we're going to do for the first shot, we're going to go to the very last keyframe of this layer right here, which is the keyframe right before the next layer. You're going to see this big blue hollowed bar right here. You're going to click on this, and you're going to hold and drag it. You're going to hold it to right before the scope. So I usually do it right here when you can see the scope on the scope crosshairs on the scope, which is kind of glitched, but that's how I do it. Or you can do one keyframe before you actually see the scope, or you can do it on the scope keyframe. It's up to you how you want to do it. I'm personally going to do it right here, the right before the scope. So now if you preview it, you can see that it picks up speed, slows down, and it picks up speed again right before the shot, and it syncs perfectly to the shot. Now what you're thinking is, oh, well, there's still space right here that we don't know what to do with. So we're just going to drag this in and fill this in like that. We're going to go and select these keyframes and control C and copy them. What you're going to do is you're just going to click add another Twixtor and make sure you set your keyframe to the same. And if you also want to make a preset of your Twixtor, you can also just set your settings how you want it, to like 60 or whatever, and you can drag this to your effects panel and click on this, and you can just make your own preset. It'll tell you like where to save it and what you name it and everything like that, and then it'll just be in there, and you can go up here to animations and then click apply animation and find your preset you made. And then next time you go to do it, like I do, I have my own preset, is I just click Control Shift Alt F at the same time, and it makes the last preset that I used in my After Effects pop up. Once we have our keyframe right here for our Twixtor, we're gonna click right here and have these three copied like we did before. We're gonna paste it in here, and you say, oh no, these aren't synced correctly, because if you see, it's not gonna match the layer. So you want to do is you want to find your syncing points for the song. So I'm gonna preview my audio. So I have 2 points of sync right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this by, I'm going to hold Alt, click on it, and then drag the last keyframe to one frame before my marker of the beat right here. And we're going to paste the same three keyframes again, and then just click Alt, drag it over to one keyframe before the shot. And you can see it's almost quickly synced up. You're going to go, well, it's not exactly where I want it to be. I want it to be more scoped in or more scoped out, whatever you want to do, right? So what you're going to do is you're going to go in here to your keyframes on the graph editor, and you're going to want to grab these 2 points right here, and then just grab one of the boxes and hold shift and just pull it up or down depending on how fast or slow you want to go. So if you pull it up, it'll go faster, and you pull it down, it'll go slower. So you can see it's scoping in and out at the last keyframe right there. I personally want it right here, the keyframe right before the shot. So I'm gonna leave it like that. So you can see the values go 175 to 50, and then it goes up to 212, and it goes down to 50 again, and then back up to 175. So it's a consistent speed at the beginning and the end, but the middle has a faster gradual point, so it keeps the nice consistency with the scope animation. So if I preview it, you can see, right? And if you also want to, you can also just do this, where instead of having 2 points, if you just want to have 1 point, you can just have one long point like this. You can just drag this, and then if you see, you're like, well, I don't have 2 points, so I can't drag the middle one up and down. So in that case, you just want to grab this bottom one and pull it up to where you want it. And if you notice this is too close to these two bottom ones, you just pull these up a little bit to just balance it out, and you're like, oh, it's too scoped in now. Just pull this back down to where you want it, and now we have a perfect speed how we want it. Now this is at 62 instead of 50, and we still have our slope speed that we wanted, so it looks like this. We're gonna go to the next layer. You wanna drag this out so there's no more open space right here, so there's actually a keyframe here. Then you wanna add your preset or add in your Twixtor. Control Shift Alt F. Make sure you have the correct key or frame rate. Go one frame forward. Make sure you have your same three original keyframes back here selected. Make sure you have them copied just like before, just to make sure. Paste it. Too long. Do I want 2 points or do I want 1 point? Let's see. I want 2 points. So I'm going to go right here in the middle. I'm going to control, or I'm going to alt drag those. Make sure it's always the last keyframe when you're dragging it. One keyframe before the marker. Paste it. Same thing again. One keyframe before the next layer. Still not synced up how I want it. pull this up just a little bit. And then sometimes if I want to mix up, if I don't want to go too fast, I sometimes grab these two or just one of them, and I pull these up just to give it a nice smoothness so it's not too fast in the middle right here. If we preview it, we got this. We have a nice jump sync right in the middle right there. So far we have our first initial buildup, which we have the other version where it's just going to be this first version where it's a slow buildup instead of a fast, slow, fast. It's going to be slow and fast. So if we go right here, we drag this down, pull this over. So far we have three types of syncing. We have the slow fast, then we have the fast slow fast, and we have the to 2 point, the fast slow fast, fast slow fast. Okay, so now this time I'm going to show you a different way of syncing just for longer shots. So let's say we have a shot where there's a lot of space between the shots like this. Like there's a huge gap like this and then the shot, right? But pretend that this is all just space between a shot. So there's two ways you can do this. So we can either go like this, we can find 2 points in a song. So like this, we can cut the layer like this, drag this over. We can just do the same thing, Control-Alt-F at our keyframe or our first layer, drag it forward, paste them, pull them over to the last keyframe this time. And then right here, the same exact thing again, one keyframe forward, pasting it, dragging it all the way over, and then one keyframe before the shot. And we can also modify this. We can drag this to exactly where we want it at. And then if this one, we also can just do something more fun. We can just make it go so fast, just like we did with the first shot. Since it's basically a brand new layer of a sync shot. So instead of doing 2 points, if we have a lot of, if we have a long period of time where there's no shot between the shots, we can always just cut it in half on a beat and it'll look perfectly fine. She walks into the room. She walks into the room. So you can see right here, it jumps right there, but it still syncs perfectly fine on the beat. So there's not a bunch of running or random stuff like scoping in and out for no reason, or like hard scoping, anything like that. And this next one, I usually call it just like the normalistic syncing. It's just a little bit different than what you normally sync with. It's just something to add more like a smoothness to the clip. If you have like a depending on like the song you have or whatever it is, you can always just use this to fall back on if you can't find a good point to sync your clips on. So what you want to do is you want to add your first keyframe, make sure you have your points set, 120, and then you want to go forward. And then this one's a little bit complicated, but it's really easy once you understand how it works. So what I do, guys, I paste this, drag this about 3/4 through right here. Then I go to the last keyframe, add one keyframe just like the last one, so 175. So now you have these four beats instead of three. It looks a bit weird, but you'll see why. So what you want to do is you want to go to this third beat right here and set this to a normal speed, like 100, so it's just the raw clip speed. Go into your graph editor, and you'll see, whoa, this looks all fucking weird and not normal, right? So first thing you want to do is you want to make sure this is correct. Yep, we're good. Okay, you want to drag this one over. You want to pull this one back up, and you hold shift, and you can drag it to make it so it's completely straight and even. Then you want to even these out so it's a nice smooth curve like this, so it's a gradual speed instead of a sharp turn. And you go, well, what about this? This looks weird and also doesn't sync correctly. You just drag this one over and you pull this one down just like this side. But instead of having it being fast, slow, fast, it's going fast, slow, normal, fast. So it's a little bit more smooth with the song you're using if you want it like that. And if you go, well, it doesn't sync, it's not fast enough or it's not slow enough, then you can always just grab this key from right here and pull up and down because it's going to always be that normalistic speed. So if you can go like this, you can see if I go around like 65, you're like, well, it's still not right. Then just pull this one down. It's always just about modifying single keyframes. If you want to, depending on what kind of clip you have, like if you have like a 120 FPS clip, you can go down to speeds of like 30, or if you have like a 50 FPS, or if you have like a 60 FPS clip, you can always bring it down to like 45. If you have a 30 FPS clip, I wouldn't go anywhere past like 75. So I want to bring mine down to about right here. This works for my clip. So if you look, we can see it goes fast, slow, normal, fast. This isn't a perfect example of a clip because there's not a whole lot going between a clip the shots because it's a shot after shot after shot, but it's always going to work depending on if there's like a long period of time between shots, but it's not super, super long where you need to cut. It's just like for that medium space where you need it. What I usually do for last shots is I add a normal Twixtor because Twixtor Pro doesn't work very well for warping for some reason for me. I'm not sure if it's just a problem with my After Effects or if it's a natural problem with Blender or with Twixtor, but this is what happens for me. So you want to just go to your frame rate, make sure it's set to the correct frame rate you have it on. Then you want to set this to best. Then you want to set this to nearest. You want to set your keyframe speed at the first keyframe, so 100. And then I do the same speed again, so I just literally just copy and paste it. And I drag it to the end like this. But instead of having it one keyframe to last, I just do one keyframe at the very end like this. And then I'll set this to a certain speed, like 20, something like this. And then I go into the graph editor, and then I make sure this fits correctly. And I just have it like gradually slow down, so it's not going to be a super, super normal speed. It's going to be like super slow like this. So you can see it slowed down the clip a lot, but it's also going to look for you different for you, because majority of the time you're going to be editing 60 FPS clips and not 120. So 100 or 60 FPS clips is going to have a little bit more warp, but don't worry about it. As long as you have RSMB on your final product, it will look normal. This is just a quick tutorial I made for some people who are asking how I sync now, because obviously it's different from when I did a couple years ago back when I was in Red. As long as you follow these fundamentals, just it's super easy just to stick in a pattern with Twixtor. It's nothing complicated, and the more you use it, the more you'll understand, the more things you can interpret your own style. This is just the easiest way of explaining it in different styles. Pretty much went over everything, like a slow fast, and then fast, slow, fast, and then a middle point, fast, slow, fast, slow, fast, and then like a fast, slow, and then a cut in the middle right here. And we have the normalized syncing, so the fast, slow, normal, fast, so it just syncs perfectly, and then the super fast, and then super slow, so it's a nice slow-mo with the animation and the kill feed. But yeah, I appreciate you guys watching the video, and I will catch you later. Peace.